You know, I think the first thing for the listeners to recognize is that, not surprisingly, about how swiftly and how strongly our professional societies and the CDC all came out roughly at the same time recommending that we offer the vaccine to pregnant and lactating women. So I think that's an important message, because at least in the United States, all these groups were just highly consistent about what they believed in terms of the importance of prevention of getting COVID-19, because they're all concerned about what the impact could be on both pregnant and as well as lactating women. You know, again, you know, I think that the most important thing is that if this isn't a topic that comes up in your prenatal care or in your meetings with your provider, it definitely needs to come up. And I think that this is the ultimate form of shared decision making. And like I said earlier, it's about weighing the risk, benefits, pros and cons. Okay. And again, you know, there's a fair amount that we do know, but there's also a fair amount that we don't know. And I know that that unknown makes people nervous, but I don't want to translate the unknown into myths that have no basis or no scientific evidence. Again, this is a once in a lifetime pandemic. The number of infections and deaths globally has been astronomical. And we finally have come to the phase where we have a vaccine, which is the ultimate prevention mechanism in terms of getting COVID-related, 19-related disease. You just need to have the conversation and understand what those risks and benefits are. And again, for our listeners who are pregnant, you know, you don't have to get the vaccine. If you feel that there is a way for you to mitigate your risk of getting COVID-19 by properly masking, properly socially distancing, washing your hands, and you think that after talking to your provider, that's the best strategy, that's okay. That's okay. I mean, we want our patients to be comfortable with that strategy, but we also want them to know that if asked, that many providers that deliver obstetrical care are going to recommend the vaccine.